morning, children. I welcome you all to today's class of English language, in which we are going to study today tenses. As I told you, children, in my previous video also, that next chapter will be your tenses. So, children, before starting of the tenses, let's have a quick revision of verbs, because tenses are completely based on verbs. Okay. So, as we have already studied, children, what is verb? Verb. A word which tells us the action and state. As we studied in the last chapter also, two types of verb, being verb and having verb. So, our being verb tells us the state of the subject or noun or pronoun, and the having verb tells us about the action of the action performed by the subject. So, for example, walk, run, sleep, cry, like this. State, like what does the subject is feeling, or the situation of the subject means, and subject means noun or a pronoun. So this we have already studied what verb is. Now again, two types of verbs are there, main verbs and helping verbs. I hope this is clear to you. Main verbs like fly, cry, sleep, the actual action, and the helping verb which support these verbs like is, am, are, was, were. This all we have this already discussed. Now we will study about the, there are two main qualities of the verb. First I'll tell you the qualities, then we will move forward to the tenses. See the two qualities which I was telling. First quality is that verb changes depending upon the subject. Means how you have to put verb, always keep on changing when the subject keeps on changing. As we have already discussed in the previous chapter, if the subject is singular or plural, then which type of verb? For example, the boy dash playing. A boy is a singular subject, so we will put there is. The boy is playing. And if the sentence is the boy is dash playing, so what will come? Are will come. Then now here is a verb used with singular subject, and are is a verb used with plural subject. We have discussed all this in detail in the previous chapter. Now, the second quality of the verb is, it changes depending upon the time. Means not, what does this mean, children? It means that form verb keeps on changing depending upon the time in which the action is being performed. This is the very same thing which we are going to study in this chapter. This is what is tenses. Tenses help us to know in which time the action is being performed. Now let's see it more clearly. Now see, children, anything which happens, either it's going to happen right now, or it might have already happened, or it will happen in the coming time. So how do we describe them? The things which are happening now is known as present. The thing which has already happened is known as past. And the thing which is going to happen is will be known as future. So these are the three tenses, present, past and future, which we are going to study. Now children, as I told you, that verb change depending upon the time. The time, it means that when is the action being performed. If the action is performed in the past, there will be, the verb will change. If the action is being performed right now, the verb will be changed. And if the action will perform in the future, then also the verb will change. Now let's see how. See the example, children. Rhea comes here. I hope you know what is the verb here. Comes is the verb. Rhea comes here. Simple sentence, Rhea comes here. This action of Rhea happened right now in the present situation of time. So this is the example of present tense. Now let's read the second sentence. Rhea came here. Rhea came here means Rhea came here in the past. Means Rhea has already came and she has gone back. So this action of Rhea was being performed in the past. Okay, so this is the past tense. Now future, Rhea will come here means Rhea is going to come here, means after maybe today, or maybe tomorrow, maybe today evening, she is going to come here. So Rhea will come here. So here children, comes verb in the present tense changes to came in the past and will come in the future. Now this is called the forms of verb. The verb has three basic forms, which we are going to study, children. The verb has three forms, present, past and future. What are these called? These are called the forms of the verb. If the situation has happened in past, then we'll put the past form of the verb. It is of present, we'll use the present form of the verb, and if it is of future, we use the future form of the verb. Now let's understand these forms of verb in little detail. First of all, we'll discuss only about the present. Okay, if any action is performed by the subject in the present situation, what verbs we are going to use? I have written few examples, children. Writes, sings, eats, draws. Now you might be thinking, children, that why I have put there S. If you remember, I've explained to you earlier when I was teaching subject verb agreement, the thing is that if the subject is singular, then verb will be used with the S. It means, for example, Rahul writes. If I'm saying Rahul writes a letter, then Rahul is a single person. So Rahul writes a letter. If I use plural, means Rahul and Raj write a letter. We are not going to put there S. So you have to remember this, children. If the subject is in singular, then verb will be with S form, S or ES. And if the subject is in plural, we will be using only write, sing, dance. We are not going to use S or ES. Please keep this thing in your mind. This is for the present form. So next we have the past form. The past form is write. If someone Rahul has written that letter, Rahul has already written the letter, then what we are going to write? Rahul wrote a letter. Wrote means Rahul has written that letter in the past. And if the Rahul is going to write in the future, then we write Rahul will write letter. So let's see one more. Rhea sings a song. Rhea sang a song. Past tense. Rhea will sing a song in the future. Now see the next one, children. Eats. He eats food. Okay. Ate for the past tense. He ate food. For the future, he will eat food. Okay. I hope now this is little bit clear, children. Let's take one more example. Draws. He draws a painting. He drew a painting means when he draw that painting in the past. He will draw the painting. So this is your present tense, this is your past tense, and this is your future tense. I repeat once again, children, please remember here, while using the verbs in your present tense, if the subject is singular, you are going to use S or ES forms of the verb. And if the subject is in plural, then you are not going to use S or ES. You will simply write there the first simple form, that is come, sing, say, write, draw. You are not going to put there S. But one thing very important is that with I, see I is a singular person, but with I we will not be using the S. With I also we will be using only the first form, only the simple form, that is come. Sing. I come. I sing. I'm not going to say I sings. I come. This is wrong. Okay. So this for present only you have to keep this thing in mind. Rest the past is simple. And the future also I hope it is understood. Now children, let's do the exercise, book exercise this so that the things will be more clear to you. Okay. Now coming to your books. Now listen, children. Coming to your book. Please, this exercise you have to do yourself. Okay. Now, let's see, children, here, as we have read all these things, simple present tense, past tense, future tense, and one thing more, children, I want to tell you, your page number 41 in your book means this page, it is wrong printed there. This is wrong. Whatever is written, whatever was written here was wrong. So, I have cut that thing and I have rewritten everything. Okay, I'll send you the pic of this also. So, please, you also correct there. Okay, children, this exercise state whether these words are in simple, past, present or future. You just have to read the words until to which form of the verb these words belong. Will play, as I explained you, will play, future, combed, past. For past you have to write P and for present you have to write PR.
scolds, present, speaks, present, will go, future, writes, present, drinks, present, shouted is your past, will bake, where will come, it will be future, cried is past, will launch is future, wrote is past. See children, on the board I wrote S with all these words. Okay, so don't get confused. S and E, where you have to put S in the present form of the verb and where you don't have to put that S, that I have explained you. Please keep this thing in your mind. Okay, now you have to fill this table. Laugh, laughed, will laugh. Fall, fell, will fall. Catch, caught, will catch. Draw, drew, will draw. Drop, dropped, will drop. Okay, sorry children, here the spelling is wrong. Just please correct it, double P. Okay, fill in the blanks with the correct form of the verbs given in the bracket. Now here you have to use all the rules which we have studied. I dash a letter to my grandfather tomorrow. Means tomorrow is coming, tomorrow is the future. So what you will write here, I will come. You will write, I will write a letter to my grandfather tomorrow. Now see. She dash for at least half an hour every evening. Every evening. This is a fact that she reads for every hour, half an hour every evening she reads. This is a fact that she is doing it on a continuous basis. So, she is a singular noun. So, with a singular noun, singular subject, we'll put the S form of the present tense. So, she reads. Okay. Next one, giraffes dash leaves. Now here, giraffes is a plural subject. So, and this sentence is in the present tense. So, we will not put S here. We will simply write eat. Okay, I hope this concept is little bit clear to you children. With the singular noun or a pronoun, we'll use the S form of the verb. Yeah, and with the plural noun or a pronoun, we will not use the S form. We will simply write the present form of the verb. See, my neighbor dash his garden yesterday. Now, here yesterday ki means, the day which has already gone. So, clean, we will put there, cleaned. Okay. The cook dash the grocery next week. Next week means in the future. So, the cook will buy. The gentleman dash at the bus stop every morning. Here children, I have written meet. I have not written meets. Why? Because gentle, it's gentleman. It is not gentleman. M-E-N man is used for a single man. And M-E-N men is used for the plural. So here is a plural word and the tense is present tense. So I'll be using meet. So gentlemen meet at the bus stop every morning. Now let's see the next one. His niece rides the horse every morning. Here also niece, children, is a singular pronoun. Sentence is in the present tense, so we are going to write rides the horse every morning. S form of the verb. Mr. Verma dash us mathematics. Teaches in this sentence again. The Mr. Verma is a singular pronoun and the sentence is in the present tense, so we are going to write teaches. The aeroplane dash over the city yesterday. Now here yesterday is coming. Yesterday means the past tense. The aeroplane flew away over the city yesterday. We dash custard tomorrow. Tomorrow means future, so we will eat custard tomorrow. I hope this exercise is clear, children. Now, so coming to the last exercise, children, I went to the beach. So you have to change it to simple future tense. So I will go to the beach. They shouted for help. This is in past tense and you have to change in present. So they shout for help. See children, here they is a plural pronoun. So I'm not going to write shouts. I will be writing shout. That is why I've written shout. She completed her lesson. This is again a past tense. Change to simple future tense. She will complete her lessons. We will enjoy our friend's birthday party. You have to change it into past tense. We enjoyed at our friend's birthday party. My parents will My parents will take me to theater this weekend. Now you have to change it into simple past tense. So my parents took me to a theater this weekend. Now coming to the next one, they shifted to Chennai. Simple future tense. They will shift to Chennai. I will eat sandwiches. Change to simple past tense. So here eat will become ate. So I ate sandwiches. And the next one, mother scolded me. Change to simple future tense. Mother will scold me. Hina, write an essay. Change to simple past tense. So you write will become Hina wrote an essay. Sudeep will make pulao for dinner. Change to simple present tense. Sudeep makes pulao for dinner. Here Sudeep is a singular noun, so we will use the S form of the present of the verb of the we'll use the S form of the verb. So your verb will be makes pulao for, makes will be your verb, pulao for dinner. Okay children, I think the exercise is also clear to you.
I hope children the things are clear to you. Now you have understood the correct use of verb in all the three tenses. Practice them. It is very easy if you understand them right now, so you're not going to face any difficulty when you reach to higher classes. Okay, then also if you have any doubt, you can clear them. Thank you children.